Hello, in this video I will be demonstrating how to use the EasyDriver stepper motor control board along with small stepper motors such as this one in your personal projects. Off and on I'll be referring to my Etch-a-Sketch machine, which uses two EasyDrivers and an Arduino Nano. Stick around to the end of the video. I plan on doing another time lapse, and I'll also leave the link for my Etch-a-Sketch video of how it works. Stepper motors are absolutely fantastic in projects where the shaft position is most important, and the EasyDriver stepper controllers are one of the cheapest and easiest ways to control small stepper motors. The EasyDriver board is readily available both on Amazon and eBay. I'll leave a link in the description. I've seen both types, one with headers pre-installed, one without. These are great for prototyping projects, but once you have your project locked down, I prefer these ones where you solder directly. Most stepper motors use two electromagnetic coils to control the position of the shaft. You can think of this kind of like a compass being controlled by a magnet. Depending on how the coils are energized and with what polarity and strength, the needle points in different directions.
If you go to smaltzhouse.com/easydriver, you'll find a plethora of information about this board. Let's start in the top right corner of this pinout, where you see the power input of 6 to 30 volts. You'll want to set the voltage depending on your project needs, and we'll talk about setting that a little bit later. If we go over here to the left corner, you'll see motor coil A and motor coil B. Now you'll have to either go to your drawing for your motor or ohm out the wires to determine which wires go to which pins. On my Etch-a-Sketch machines, red and green are coil A and yellow and blue are coil B. Now it's really not a big deal if you get coils A and coil B mixed up. That won't have a big impact on your performance. What would matter though is if you had one wire from one coil and one wire from another. One thing very important to remember is not to unplug the wires from the stepper motor controller while the EasyDriver is powered. Doing so will burn up your board and you will have to buy another one. Alright, moving down to the bottom left corner, you'll see the ground and 5 volt output. This can be used to power your microcontroller such as an Arduino. Now if you're using a 3.3 volt system, such as a Raspberry Pi, you'll want to put a little blob of solder right here on this jumper, and that will switch the output to 3.3 volts. Okay, over here in the bottom right, we have the inputs and connections to our microcontrollers. Ground just goes to ground on your Arduino or other microcontroller. And your step and direction are what actually control the stepper motors. Your direction, say if it were high, maybe it would go clockwise, low would go counterclockwise. It may be switched depending if you hooked up your motor coils A and B backwards, but that's easy to figure out. And then the step input just takes a pulse. So a high followed by a low would advance the stepper motor by one step, or my Etch-a-Sketch machine has 200 steps, so that would mean you would have to do a high and a low 200 times in order to advance it one full rotation. I've never actually used the sleep input pin or the PFD input. If you're interested in those, read more about them in the website. Many people complain about how slow stepper motors are. And while they're not known for their speed, they can be made to spin faster than most people think. Part of it could be due to their software, how fast they're sending the pulses to the stepper motor. Part can be due to their voltage setting on their board, and we'll talk about that a little later. But a lot of it has to do with this MS1 and MS2 pin. One of the things I'm not a big fan of on the EasyDriver board is that by default they're both set to high, which means that the driver board are in the highest resolution setting, which also means the slowest speed setting. So a stepper motor that's say 200 pulses per revolution would become 1600 pulses per revolution. And in the case of my Etch-a-Sketch machine, where I was more concerned with speed rather than resolution, I wanted both MS1 and MS2 set to low. So in order to do that, you need to jumper those pins to one of the ground pins on the board.
Another complaint you'll hear from EasyDriver users is heat. And in particular, this chip right here can get very hot and burn you. And these motors as well can get very hot. This has to do with the current setting. The EasyDriver is capable of sourcing 3/4 of an amp to each coil in the stepper motor. That might work for one of these big NEMA 23 motors, but for this NEMA 17 that I'm using in my Etch-a-Sketch, it's too much. And so that extra current will mean the motor will get hot, the wires will get hot, and eventually it will ruin my motor. For stepper motors, the higher the current, the higher the holding torque. But each motor has a limit. In the case of this motor, the limit is 1/3 of an amp. So we need to adjust the EasyDriver to be at or below 1/3 of an amp, and I'll show you how that's done. On each EasyDriver, you'll find this little screw right here, and this is probably the most overlooked feature on the EasyDriver itself. And by adjusting that screw, you can increase or decrease the current going to each coil of the stepper motor. If you turn it all the way to the maximum, it will source the full 3/4 of an amp, and if you do that, I would encourage you to put a heat sink on this chip. But in the case where I'm trying to get 1/3 of an amp on my stepper motor, I needed to dial it down. The way to find out how much current the EasyDriver is sourcing is to connect the black on your multimeter to one of these ground terminals and measure the voltage over here at test point 1. So I'm reading about 1.8 volts. When we go to the EasyDriver schematic, we can see that a voltage of 2 equals a current of 1/3 of an amp. And that's what I needed to stay below, so having it set at 1.8 volts should get me around 300 milliamps or so. This sheet's also important for determining what size power supply you'll need. So if you're using the full 5 volts, which gives you 833 milliamps, you probably want a 2-amp power supply because this is just supplying one of the two coils. If you're using a battery as your power supply, you may want to consider turning down the current on your EasyDriver controller to the lowest setting that will give you enough torque to do your job. One thing to remember about stepper motors is that they are always drawing current even when they're not spinning. If you're using a battery, you may also want to consider using this enable pin to turn on and off the motors at different times in your program depending on your needs. Where I'm using a power supply in my Etch-a-Sketch project, I decided not to use the enable pin. But as you can see, when the EasyDriver is energized, I'm unable to turn the motor by hand. When I put a jumper wire in between the enable pin and the 5 volt pin, I'm able to turn the motor and draw a line on the Etch-a-Sketch even though the EasyDriver is powered up. This could also be done by connecting one of my digital pins on the Arduino to the enable pin on the EasyDriver. Giving a high signal would disable the motors, giving a low signal would turn them back on.
Let's go over some really basic Arduino code to get your EasyDrivers working with your stepper motors. First thing we need to do is assign Arduino pins to correspond with the direction and step connections on your EasyDriver. In this case, I've used pins 2 and 3. We want to set those pin modes to output, and we start out by setting them both low. Okay, let's check out the loop now. Here we have a digital write to the step pin high, and the EasyDriver will recognize the rising edge and advance the stepper driver one step. We're going to hold that there for 5 milliseconds and then set it back to low, and then wait another 5 milliseconds. Now that will take approximately 10 milliseconds, which means that if we have a 200 step stepper motor, it will take about 2 seconds to make a full revolution. Now if we want to speed that up, for example, we could change the delay to be 1 millisecond, and that would give us about 2.5 RPM on our stepper motor driver. Okay, so let's say that we want the motor to go 10 times as fast. Well, couldn't we just change this one millisecond delay into a 100 microsecond delay? Wouldn't that have the effect that we want? Well, it's not that simple. Let's get into stepper motors and explain how we can make our stepper motors faster and how we know what the limitations of our stepper motors are.
Before we get into the speed calculations, let's go back to the schematic for the motor and check out some of the most important values for the speed calculation. First is step angle. You see this step angle of 1.8. That is what corresponds to 200 pulses per revolution. We also want to look at the maximum current for this motor, which is 1/3 of an amp. And this is kind of counterintuitive, but the higher the current, the slower the motor will go. So if you want your motor to go faster, you actually have to set the current on the EasyDriver lower. Inductance is probably the biggest factor in this whole equation. The higher this number, the slower your stepper motor will turn. So if you want a fast stepper motor, find one with low inductance.
Okay, so over here I have the formula for calculating the maximum hypothetical speed for your stepper motors. And I've plugged in all the data from the data sheet, which gives me an approximate speed of 2.2 revolutions per second. So what if I want my stepper motor to go faster? What can I do about that? Well, I can't change inductance, I can't change the number of steps, but I can change the current and voltage. The EasyDriver can go up to 30 volts, so what if I change this to 24 and recalculate? I've now doubled my speed. Now let's look at current. Perhaps I don't need a lot of torque for my project, and I cut the current in half, I've doubled my speed again. So as you can see, there are some ways to get a little more speed out of your stepper motor.
Well, hopefully you found the information in this video useful. If you did, please do me a favor and click the like and subscribe buttons so that I can share more videos like this in the future. Okay, that's enough of me talking. How about we move on to the demonstration? Let me know in the comments below if you can figure out who is drawn on the Etch-a-Sketch machine.